Working, yeah. Hi, my name is Ruslan. I'm working in a company Timescale, which develops a time series database as extension to PostgreSQL, and which means that we are producing open source code. And I recently joined the company, so working with the code, I learned how to do open source code and requirements for there, and this inspired me for this talk. Unfortunately, we don't develop in C++, but in C, as PostgreSQL, mainly stay on this. So this is more like a lightning talk with a demo, so it will take longer time than usual lightning talk. So before I go to open source way of having a commit history, I would like to present how it's in, for the closed source it can look like. I mean, it's in, basically developers, they do their commits and the way how they prefer to do. And usually you normally will do more commits than it's necessary for entire feature because it's much easier to have development process. In the case of the closed source, it's there are no public that will look to the code, so it's up to the company and developers to decide how good they want to have the commit history, and it can be looking like this railroad which doesn't feel safe. So, and in such case, there are no rewrites on the commits, and all the work is merged back into the feature or into the master branch. There some work can be done, for example, to use this as a log and maybe to have easy way to find like feature commits through the mandatory merges and commit messages. For example, this one is a commit message with link to the GitHub issue and a short description of the commit. So, then if you use git log merges, you can get all the merge commit messages and see what actually was done during a certain period of time. For this, you should avoid do fast forward, otherwise it will just merge without merge commit and without merge, and then necessary to do commit message. Or if you use GitHub, you just do pull request and it automatically recreates for you this merge commit message. So now let's go to their expectations for which are common. I don't know how much is common, but it's available in many open source projects that you have plain flat commit history, single line, and each commit message, each commit is meaningful like implementing a feature, fixing a bug, implementing an additional task or story, so it's easy to follow. To be able to reach this, it's necessary to actually do some rewrites of your history because it's not a way how developers develop, and if you push them to do this, you probably will affect the quality of the code and development time. So for this, Git rebase can, it's squashing commits together with help of Git rebase, also amending commits to existing. And the main tool is, if we work with Git, and this presentation is focused on Git, is to use Git rebase command. Of course, in all cases, you will get commits, it's conflicts, it's unfortunately unavoidable, and it needs to be solved in independently on the strategy which is used. For open source, it's usually a requirement to fork the repo. So this means that all your history rewrites, they go into your fork and they don't go to the main repository. Just a little bit about contributing through forks. So as I mentioned, it's no direct rewrites to the main open source project repo or product. And then you create pull request. And for example, in GitHub, it's possible to set that you require rebase. So it becomes the result of the work is a single commit which is put on top of the current state of the master branch in the main repo. Actually, this now this forking is available from GitHub and the for private repo, so you can do private fork of a private repo and it will be private according to their organization rules. And command git remote helps you to manage your remotes. And so, for example, to create new remotes, like you can. So I will go here. So basically, for the naming convention, you normally have your own fork is the origin name, and upstream is their open source, at least the open source repo where you take bits to continue your development work. Also, it's nice to have collaborators work, for example, for review or working together on a project. And in such case, one of the suggestions to use git fetch and then git reset with heart to this collaborator branch. Okay, so let's look now to the actual working with commit history and starting to rewrite. So on the left, it's so there was a feature branch was started from master branch, everything was good, but at some moment some other developer completed his or number of developers completed their projects. So here it's a three blue dots, three different commits which were completed and merged to master. So now it's time to move your feature on the latest master and do the rebase. This is done by git rebase and, for example, on master branch. If there are any conflicts, they need to be resolved and you can do continue. So, and then at the end, you have your feature branch on top of the master branch. You can continue to work or finalize your work finally and create pull request. I prefer to do more often this rebase because then it's less merge commits at a time and probably easy to learn how to work with code within a team or with others so you don't get too many conflicts. So now I will go to a demo. So I prepared a number of branches for the demo, and for this clean rebase I will go to branch I want to feature. Oh no, sorry. First, I will go back to master and we'll show what we have there. So this is so here I show 10 last commits. I actually use public repository of timescale database and. The feature branch will be started from this fixed Windows compilation commit. So I go now to the feature branch. And show its commits. Yeah. Okay. Is it big enough or should I increase font? And this font, do I need to increase now? Okay, I see no complaints. So basically, now it's three commits which were done by there in the feature branch and on top of this fixed Windows compilation, which is in master branch. So and after this fixed Windows master Windows compilation master, there was like 7 or 8 commits. So now we will rebase the prepared commits. They don't have conflicts. So it will be simple. So we do rebase on master. And it writes to you that it applies first commit 1, then commits 2, and then commits 3 on the top. So now it's the same as on the picture. So we have these three commits applied on the master, and then there are other commits. So this is simple. Next step is now the work is finished, is squash all the commits, these small commits into one feature commit which implements the entire feature or fixes a bug. And for this, to do the squash, it's to use Git rebase with interactive option, and you need to provide what on top of which commit it should be applied. You can say just master apply on top of you need to say parent commit from where to start to do your work. So we want to do it from this commit, so it's possible to say master or to say like last two commits. I will go back to the example. And now I want to do this squash. So I do rebase interactive and the shortcut I, and I will do it on top of master. So now it shows me that there are three commits and asks me what I want to do. And basically I want to reward the first commit to make it nice commit message. And then the other two, it's fixed up. So they just added to the first commit, but don't ask for any message. So now, and F is a shortcut, so you can see all, it actually prints all the commands that is available. Now it asked me to improve the message, and let's say we call it implement feature. On the top. Okay, so now it will save and will push. So now we can see, let's say take five, that we have implement feature as a one single commit on top of master. So we've got what is on this picture. If you have more work that, like, you created pull request and there was reviewers required to do some fixes, you want to bring to the same commit, and it can be done with help of amend option in the commit. So I will let's do some changes. I will start code editor. Let's change this to capital. Stage it, and then instead of creating separate commit, we add to the last commit. And since I'm satisfied with my commit message, it didn't change anything, I will say no edit. So this change now is amended to the commit, so it's the same history, no changes in the history. Now let's look to more interesting case when actually it's a team working on a feature, so single developer will have own branch from the feature, and this feature is was a branch from master branch. So what it demonstrates here, there was two more commits in the master, and now the task is to rebase feature on master and rebase mine on the feature. It's quite straightforward if there are no conflicts. So use git checkout feature, go to the feature and do rebase. After this, what happens with the developer branch, with mine branch, it's a separate history. So now it needs to be fixed, and doing just rebase will do it fine if there are no conflicts. So I will demonstrate this now. I go to another branch. So so it's basically what I started previous demo with the same example. So now I do rebase on master. So it's now on top of the master, and now I go to the mine branch. And you can see there So it's on top of commit one, which we've seen before. And then there was two developer commits, A and B. And the master branch is still on fixed Windows compilation, like I showed in the example. So now we do just rebase on the feature branch. And it's applied only A and B. So now the history is nice as in the picture as expected. So 1, 2, 3 commits on top of master and then A, B. So it's nice, beautiful. So let's go to the last more interesting example when we actually have a conflict. So basically this purple commit is going to conflict with their commit in master and will require to do rewrite. So after their rebase, it will be necessary to resolve the conflicts, and this commit will be different now. It has different changes, and Git will recognize that it's not anymore the same commit. So it will recognize that your developer branch has different commit, even that the name is the same, because the code is different. If this feature branch rebase was done by some other developer, not you yourself, you need to actually your local feature branch needs to be reset by heart. Or you can use from upstream when you will do rebase work. So if you try to apply rebase directly, what it will Git do, it will try to apply this commit on top. It will not recognize that this actually was similar commits and will not ignore it. So, but this is not what we want. We actually want to get that only your own commits are applied on top of a feature. For this, Git rebase provides onto option. And in onto option, you specify what branch you want to rebase on, or what commit rebase on. So basically to rebase on this commit. And then it's necessary to specify from what is parent commit. After this, you want to pick up their commit. So we want to pick up this two, then parent commit is this one. Now I will do a demo. So I go feature. So I have a special commit with conflict and on top of fixed bug with histogram function in parallel, commit in master. So now I try to do rebase on master. And now it complains that I have conflict. So let's solve. So here I use Visual Studio Code, which shows nicely me what is conflicting. I will accept the current change, but I need to do some change to make it more interesting. So I need to, I'm doing some adjustment. So now it's done and I can continue rebase. Let's see if I didn't do any mistake. Yeah. So it's now after this adjustment, it's Git applied commit 1, and then 2 and 3. And we can see that it's now applied on top of master. So now I will demonstrate to use onto. So I switch to main branch. Let's do 10. So now it's two A and B commits on top of 1 and 2 and 1 with conflict on top of previous state of master. So let's try to do rebase on and see what will happen. And I do interactive to demonstrate Git. Yeah, of course I do it on myself. Sure. So now it shows it wants to reapply the commit 1. And then apply A and B as I showed in there on the slide. So I do rebase abort because it's not a way how I want to do. It's actually possible. Let's go back. to this one, it's possible to here actually to say just ignore, drop this commit, and then it, everything will be fine. But if you have 10 or 20 conflicting commits, it becomes too much work. So on to easy rescue. So git rebase onto, and then we want to do rebase on the feature branch, and the parent commit is going to be this one. Or I can say just head to. Oh yeah, I will say just head to. Now it's applied just A and B. So without, so you have, you don't need to be scared and think how it will do it. You just say, okay, this is my commit. This is what I want to apply. And look, just demonstrate what is the result. So now it was master, then it was commit one with conflict that was result on feature branch. Here we have feature branch, and then main branch is applied on top. So basically, this is what I wanted to talk and just conclusion or to demonstrate. So clean, you work on your personal fork, and you can clean up the commit history to make it nice, as I showed on there, one of the initial slides. And for this, use git rebase with interactive and onto options. I put actually link about good commit messages, how to, which gives good suggestions how to name your commit, so it's easy for other contributors to understand what is happening there. When you finish with your work, you do pull request and you rebase, and you move your work through rebase. And one thing, note I want to give, since this process of reviewing a pull request might take time, and since it amends commits to the first one, the time of this commit will be old. So it may be a few days old. So it's not really nice. And this can be fixed by using amend and reset author. It basically will reset the timer to the current time. OK, any questions? I don't know how much time left.
So what's your what's your idea on review commits? I like having review commits in the Git history. So it's recorded.
Yes, here it's not, it will not go there. GitHub, the pull request will be still there, and all their reviews will be there. So it doesn't change anything in the GitHub.
You don't use GitHub, right?
Then you don't have this feature, no. And then basically you can, then in such cases, maybe you don't want to squash commits so often, and you want to bring commits which reflects review of comments. Question?
Partial answer to the previous question. Project I used to work on used Garrett for code review, so that each commit message has a unique identifying tag.
Yeah.
Given a previous comment, you can still see it from the latest version.
Because all these rewrites, all this rebase, they will not reuse the same commit. Actually, it will create a new commit. So,
something else that is logic.
So, for where I did. So, here I was showing that it's 948. And after rebase, it's not 948, it's another hash.
Okay.
So it's, yeah, you just need tool.
Do you think it makes sense to postpone squashing after the pull request commands are?
I personally prefer squash before go to the pull request for two reasons. One reason, it's easy to see, I mean, it depends, of course, on the work, but since if I do it first review, I want to see everything together. I don't go through the separate things. And second, I want to see that the person will not forget to squash later on. But if, for example, I did one review and there was comments address, maybe as a separate commit it's useful.
Okay.